one is VFD. Today we are going to see the VFD control and what are the parts of VFD. This one is a VFD. This one is incomer, this one is outgoing fermenter. These are all for signals, that means the BMS signals. So see here deeply the remote switch off and DC input and DC output to BMS, start stop signals and status signals. The all the signals will be mentioned here. So this one is motor signal and this one is incoming supply. So see here, this is our indication lamps, the ROABs and run, stop, trip and start push button, stop push button. This one is handoff auto and this one is emergency stop push button. So see here inside, so this one is control fuse and ROAB indication fuses and this one is relay 1, relay 2 and relay 3 for the control purpose. And this one is main conductor and this one is ELCB, maybe here coming for MPCB. I removed this one, so that's why I'm not in a pair here. This is for the programming keys for PFD. So this is where I show it for later. So this is the display, program display. So inside of PFD we need to connect some points. So here I connected in some points, though 17 and 18, the last 3 points, that means the 25, 26, 27, and at these points are DC supply in and out, and 17, 8 is for the start and stop command to the VFD. See here, this is one for incoming supply of VFD, so this is for outgoing supply. So this is outgoing to motor for through VFD. So this one is incoming for supply. So this is the old system we need to use for the small, simple and purpose simple driving of VFD. So after that we are going to see the control diagram. So this is for control diagram. So this is one very simple control diagram. So VFD control diagram. So first of all, VFD means variable frequency drives. So already I explained the all the VFD basics. So this is a very important session for the control. So now I am going to explain the simple way of controlling the VFD. So first of all, we need to mention the what's the auxiliary supply. That means maybe the 230 voltage AC or 24 voltage DC. So whatever you have the VFD's configuration, based on you can select the auxiliary supply. So here I select for 230 voltage. So here I showed already for emergency push button. This is for the emergency purpose. You can push this one, the whole system going to shut down. So that's why we are providing for the emergency push button on here. And then this one, this control fuse. For the whole system, we need to provide some protection. So that's why we need to give the control fuse. So purpose of we are giving control fuse on here. So maybe the after the VFD, we are going to connect the motor. So after this control diagram, I show you the power diagram also. So it's roughly drawn here. So this is the incoming, and then VFD, through the VFD we will take the output to motor. So this is the incoming, and then see here. So after that, the MPCP is NC. The MPCP is NC conductor through we take the supply. So here three position switch, that means the hand off auto. You can select the three modes, that means hand operation or otherwise app operation, off, otherwise auto. So this is here we select hand. So this is a stop push button. You can, this one is a start push button. So this part is called for hand operation. So you can press start, the R1 coil is energized. So that time the start push button go back. So that's why we need to put R1's NO conductor on here. So that's why the continuous is switch on, and this R1 is going to switch on for the main conductor of C1. So this main conductor will be shown in here. So this is our main conductor. So C1, so already shown in the structure So this is the main conductor C1. So if we switch on the power R1, the main conductor C1 will be automatically switched on. So at the time the R1 is switched on, so the R1 is going to switch on the VFD start signal. That means the R1, the close and the start signal. So VFD having some VFD, this is for auto. So after sometimes I explain the auto. See here, now the R1 is closed, that time the C1 is closed, that means C1 switch run, the VFD also switch run through R1, so the motor gets supply. So this is the manual operations. So that time we need for indications. That means if you stop, the stop indication will be ramped will be low. If you start, the start indication will be low. If in case any of problems, that means that fault, at that time the VFD send the fault signal to the R2 relay, that time the R2 relay coil energized, so the R2 NMOS connect going to close, that time the trip indication will be shown. So that time we get a trip signal from the outside of the panel. So this is the dimension in 2, that means MCCB having a some NMOS conductor, that one also finding in some trips, that means MPCP motor protection circuit breaker, so that one also giving supply. So this is for start from VFD signal. So all the VFD having in this signal for start stop, so that signal I used in here. So this R2, that means the fault comes, the R2 will open, that time the start going to switch off. So the hand off auto operation we can do in here. Otherwise if you made auto operation, you can switch on the supply through a PLC, SCADA, of any other control system you have, you can switch on this through the auto operation. That time also the same like that will be performed here. The R1 is your coil energized, the R1 will be closed for start side, and then the C1 coil also closed. So that's the purpose we need to make this control diagram. So this R1 always going to starting coil, and R2 going to the fault coil, and C1 is a main conductor coil. So here PLC will be for auto operation, this MPCB for fault protection. That means the fault occurs, the MPCB going to open the circuit, and the total circuit going to switch off sometimes. So otherwise, see here, this is for totally controlled circuit. So if you maybe can got some confusion of this circuit, I show the power diagram. So after that you can clear this one also, because of the which one is first, which one is second, you don't know. That means the main supply LCBs and the MPCBs. So after that I show you the power diagram, the what's the performance of power diagram. Maybe here we do for some special one, this R2 was NV, another one NV coil going to we make on here. So this is one another one interlocking, that means the fault is not clear, this system is not going to switch on. So that's why this is interlock I put in here, that means the N2 NC coil on here. So this is a system we are going to control the VFD per simple way. So after that I show you the power diagram. So this is one power diagram. See here, this is a power diagram of VFD. So first one is ELCB, that means the earth leakage circuit breaker, that means the fire earth leakage fault protection. This is one RYB neutral and earth supplies. So ELCB, earth leakage circuit breaker, that means the earth leakage protection, MPCB motor protection circuit breaker. So the motor protection circuit breaker giving for overload protection and overcurrent protection. So this one is a main conductor, that means the switching purpose of VFD supply. So this is our VFD. VFD control the motor's speed based on the frequency. This is the final step for motor. After that, what's the purpose of this motor? Maybe this motor giving run the some applications, blowers or any of centrifugal fans or a booster pump, any of the application the motor going to run. So this is a power diagram VFD, and this is totally called power diagram. So this is for indication lamp fuse, and this is one control circuit. I mean the control circuit terminals. So this is for totally simple way of how to make VFD. If you have any doubt, please come on here. Thank you for watching.